Okay, hello everybody, and welcome back to The Witcher 3 Hearts of Stone DLC, where we're gonna go talk to Shani, I guess. That's what we're gonna do. And talk about the Von Everick family crypt. How exciting. Hey, Shani, it's been a while. How's it going? Let's talk about dead people again. Since the last time I saw you, you were trying to bring back a dead person. I was warned that I was going to need a lot of money for this, so if I end up not having enough, I will maybe have to go do some other smaller missions to make up for it, or to make up any money. Don't be bouncing your baby in the rain, lady. Jeez, that is a very bright white baby, too. It's like incredibly pale baby. But, yeah, so if I end up having to do that, I don't know, I might live stream it or something. Probably won't include it, just running around doing little things, getting money. Just because I want this playlist to be focusing on the DLC, not anything little extra. How do I get into this place? Where's the door?
Life's wet enough.
Oh, hey, look, a medical sign. Okie dokie. You upstairs? Whoa.
I've tested the slime samples. I believe I'll be able to brew an antidote.
Good. A pox in an army can prove more ravaging than even their fiercest foe. Your service will be recognized.
How? Will I get a toad-shaped medal?
The army's not got any medal like that.
Geralt? Are you alright? What's that on your face?
Long story.
We're conducting important business. Yous can catch up later.
Yes. Right. I'll get to work on the antidote. Shouldn't take long.
You're just gonna sit here?
Tasty number, that medic. Not like a scholar at all.
Interesting. Curious to know. What do scholars look like to your mind?
Well, all that reading's hard on the eyes, right? So they wear spectacles.
Oh, aye. Thick ones, propped on wrinkled noses, and their clothing frumpy at best.
Who've they got to dress up for? The books?
Fascinating, really. But if I were you, I'd make sure no medic ever overhears you.
Why's that?
Because when you get cut in a battle, she might just refuse to stitch you back up.
You're a lucky bastard, witcher. We've seen her making eyes at you.
Not just like now?
Isn't that right? Admit it. You fancy her too, eh?
No.
Sorry, none of your business.
Come on. This some kind of secret? You embarrassed? She's quite fetching, and you're, well, none too handsome, but a witcher.
None too... For some reason, people... Come the now. Guys seem to think fetch I'm ugly, but the girls seem to think I'm beautiful. I don't want to be rude, but...
There's no denying her beauty.
Yeah, okay.
But... She's not my type.
Yeah, okay, that was good.
Talking out your ass, mate.
I have a beautiful black, raven-haired woman.
Catch. She looked at me like she does you. I'd not dally long thinking.
Here's the medicine. It's a strong solution, so careful with the dosage. Each patient gets exactly 2 drops after meals, 3 times a day. At the most, in 3-4 days, the infection should recede.
She hasn't even tested it. How does she know?
In Redania's glorious name.
Well, I mean, these soldiers are, you know, they're soldiers, but
serving
they're polite.
The Redanian cause now.
I serve individuals. I treat them. That they're Redanians is coincidental. I'd help Nilfgaardians as well, were I in a position to. Kedwenis, Edirnian, elves, dwarves, halflings, the same. Come on, Geralt. You know me.
Aside from the incident in the sewers, we last saw each other. Must have been in Vizima.
Yes. Yes. When it was ravaged by the Catriona.
Feels like a century ago. Where have you been? What have you been doing since?
Well, I left Vizima and returned to Oxenfurt, proceeded to finish my doctorate, and then opened a practice. Shortly thereafter, war broke out, and I was press-ganged into the Redanian Medical Corps.
Ah!
So what now? Radovid's dead.
Yes, Radovid's dead!
But the war's not over yet. The chaos continues. I'm still very much needed.
Though she makes really strange facial expressions.
At least I live at home now, and I treat the ill, as is my calling. Though I must always be ready, for at any time the Redanians might knock with some painfully urgent assignment.
Well, she does not seem to like where she's at right now.
Shani, I need your help this time.
I'd guess this wasn't a social call. All right, tell me what you need. Is it at all related to that mark on your face? And you must tell me what happened in the sewers.
Yeah, why didn't she, like, come try to find me or something?
Where do I start? All right. Monster in the sewers turned out to be a giant toad, and this toad was actually a prince, and Ophiri wanted that.
She's not gonna believe me.
Duchess.
It's the truth. Uncolored, I swear. When I killed the toad, some Ophiri soldiers led by a mage showed up, captured me. A man named Gontaro Dim freed me.
Who's this?
Could be a mage, a demon, or a djinn.
You don't know?
He's very powerful. That's all I need to know. He helped me out of a bind. Now he expects me to fulfill some nobleman's wishes in return. First one's to summon the ghost of his brother, then show him the time of his life.
Amuse a ghost? How do you intend to do that?
Not my chief concern at the moment. Gotta find his grave and summon him first, then we'll see.
But that's necromancy. It's extraordinarily risky and involves higher magic.
Odim told me how to do it. No sorceress or necromancy involved. Gave me this. Concoction that summons ghosts. I'll need a censer, too.
Well, that can be arranged. They keep one in a storehouse at the academy. I can fetch it for you.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. But I still don't like this.
Don't whine, that's
Neither
so rude.
Neither do I, but I don't really have any options. Gotta summon that ghost.
I understand. Whose ghost is it?
Olgierd von Everek's
She's
brother.
Being very chill about this.
Von Everek?
Except not now.
In my
she never looks me in the eye.
We had to choose an elective. My options were Pearls of Wisdom from the Hierarchs, or Famous Redanian Dynasties. I chose the latter. Here it is. Von Igrid, Von Estiken, Von Everek. It says Olgierd had a brother named Vladimir. He lies in the family crypt near their manor.
Thanks. Knew I could count on you.
That's I'm scholarly off. Types.
The crypt's described as quite a work of art. I'd love to see it. Why don't I bring the censer? We can meet at the entrance.
Yay! It's a date. It's a date. I love these houses. They're so, they're so richly colored. I like them. Sorry. Like rich wood paneling and like darker colors. I like them. With the red. I like them. I've seen pictures of Geralt with the long hair and I forgot that he's ever had it in my game. It just looks so weird now. I much prefer him with the hair he's got now. Oh, wow. Okay, well, let's just fast travel then. Wow, you're far away. Out in the middle of nowhere. Okay. I think the path is taking me out the front gate, which is good. That was good, though, that in the cutscene that girl did say that Radovid's dead. Otherwise, I'd have been like, what? That guy's voice. Jeez, all these DLC areas I've never been to. Looks like the Garin estate might actually be closer. Oh, but that's the... I mean, shoot, that's right close to the old estate. Yeah, let's just go there. I summon ye, horsey. Let me on. Okay. And we're off. I'm hoping this trail basically takes us to where we need to go. Take the left one, take the left one. Oh no. Hey, merchant. Hey, wait, come here.
Move it.
Do you have a lot of money? Because I have some swords and stuff that are really expensive.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock.
Oh, you don't have any money. Sure. Okay. Should be good for now, I guess. Got rid of a couple of my heavier items.
Farewell.
Thank you, my good man.
Good man.
Where did I put my water? No, Geralt, don't follow that path. But all the DLC areas are...
Come on now.
Are in places I've not even been close to. I wonder... Looks like there's still people working here.
Hey, yeah.
Man, this looks like the house from the new Resident Evil 7. I've not played it, I've just watched Let's
not
Plays
so
of it.
Fast, Roach.
Because I'm a coward and I would not be able to play that game. Where are we going? Oh, the crypt, right. This is the house, right? So we gotta get to the crypt, which is gonna be in a little bit of a different place. Oh, are you just frolicking amongst the storm's clearing up. Oh my gosh, look how epic Geralt looks.
Pretty damn hot.
What? Pretty damn hot, Geralt. Don't worry about it. Oh my god. That was so perfectly timed. Oh my gosh. My gosh. Aw, now are we falling in
never
love with you?
This side of you?
What side is that?
How
the
do
back
I
side?
Put this? Your romantic side? Used to seeing you surrounded by bandages and medicine vials, often covered in blood.
Well, that's because you usually come round while I'm at work. Off duty now, waiting for you, weaving a garland for the wedding.
Nimble hands you got there.
I should hope so. I'm a surgeon.
It's true.
Think I prefer you using them this way.
Less blood?
More beauty.
Oh my gosh.
There's a beauty to surgery, I assure you.
I know. Just out here, in this landscape, it does more for
me. Oh, Geralt, would you just stop?
Remember to bring the sensor?
Of course. Some soldiers nearly caught me slipping it into my satchel. Wasn't sure what you needed it for, so I also took a mix of amber, aniseed, and juniper. All rather smoky when lit.
Thanks. Might come in handy.
Shall we?
She's very cool with the raising of a ghost, apparently.
The tome was spot on. This is impressive.
Yeah, too bad it's falling apart.
The family hit on hard times. No coin to splurge on such luxuries.
Why doesn't he just come back and renovate his old house? Probably got bad memories here or something.
Ooh, that looks just a little too creepy for me.
Don't have to come if you don't want. Wait here.
I like that idea.
You went into a sewer!
Just yell.
What kind of trouble could I get into that I could not get out of with your help?
This is no crypt. It's a full-blown mausoleum.
Definitely falling apart, though. Money! Oh, I guess I could always go, exchange some money, too. Whoa. Like, I'm sure I've got some money that I can trade out. I'm just stealing from the dead. Well, the dead don't need it. Nah. Dang.
Wraiths. Knew this wouldn't be easy.
Of course there's a wraith. Hybrid. Is it cursed? Oh, there's the... It might be cursed. Spectre. Yep. Yay!
Sure hope so.
Essence of Wraith. Around. Oh, I'm looking around, buddy. What's up with that? Obviously a big, you know, pedestal bowl-shaped object in the middle of a room all by itself is going to be very important. Oh.
Tombstone. Inscriptions almost worn off completely.
Okay. I might not even take the money except for the fact that I was warned that I'm gonna need a lot of money, so.
Kestetis? Not who I'm looking for.
Do I have to, like, know where he is?
Eulalia von Evereck died in 1250.
The game's probably like, it's in the center of the room. We lit it up for you. I'm like, yes, yes. Oh, hey.
Probably shouldn't touch that.
Why?
Vladimir von Evereck. son of Bohumil and Christina. There you are. Now for the ritual. Gotta spread the incense throughout the crypt, every room.
What? Okay. Do I already have it in? Yeah. There you go. Oh. Don't mind me. Come on. Okay. Whoa. Well, thank you, my good man. What did you do to get stuck back here? Did someone, like, log, did they, like, shore up this wall specifically to kill you in here? It sucks. Major suckage.
Life and death, fire and blood. Return and walk midst the living, ye who have departed. Arise as a friend, for I am no foe.
I was like, the candles are going out!
Arise from the dust, ye whose blood I have brought. Arise as a friend, for I am no foe. Return and walk midst the living, ye who have departed. Life and death, fire and blood.
Whoa.
Time to light the votive fire.
Don't mind me, I'm just stealing from the dead. Cause the dead don't need it. I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm glad Geralt knows what he's doing. Ooh, pretty!
Fire and blood, life.
How do you
death.
Know the words?
I summon ye, whose blood I have brought.
Ew, gross. We have to put the blood in our mouths and then spit
fire
it.
Fire and blood, life and death.
You have summoned me, stranger. Why?
Name is Geralt. Came to wake the ghost of Vladimir von Everek.
Who you are and why you've come matter little. For you'll not leave this place alive.
Are you Vlad's ghost?
Who asks after my grandson?
It matters not, Honoratina. What I wonder is how this mortal obtained the family's blood. For Von Everick's rise only for Von Everick blood.
True. Yet to my knowledge, only one of our line yet lives. Olgierd.
Then we converse with the man who spilled the blood of your grandson, Kestetis.
Mean none of you are Vladimir? It's Olgierd, his brother, who sent me.
You will meet Vlad soon enough. Yet Olgierd, you will never see again.
Why are you guys being all, like, aggressive? Jeez. I think I came across as quite reasonable.
For Olgierd's blood.
Olgierd? Why do you guys like Olgierd? He let your family fall to ruin.
I'll tear you to shreds.
Such creepy old people.
Yeah.
didn't spill nobody's blood. Just took what was offered.
My, my. Ornery horse sons those Von Emmerichs, eh?
Took your time.
The rogue you seek. Vladimir Von Emmerich, brother to Olgierd. Forgot I cannot even scratch my stones. Though in point of fact, they've not itched much since I died.
Didn't want to fight your family. They started it.
I'm dead, not blind. I preferred to see how you'd handle those snobby pricks. And Grandmum, too. Besides, what harm could you do them? They're dead as it is.
You're enjoying yourself.
Now tell me how you came into Olgierd's blood. If you hurt him, I fear I shall have to kill you.
Got it from a mutual acquaintance of mine and Olgierd's. I'm here on business.
I'm a swithing corpse, with no interest in important matters, yours or any other buggers. The sole thing I miss is feasting, corporal diversion, so to speak. But alas.
Get a lot of visitors?
At times, not often. For when someone does drop by, the whole band comes out to play.
Fun-loving family.
True. We're famed for our love of revelry and rumbles. We Von Emmerichs have brawled and raided for generations. It's tradition. Naturally, with raids comes loot. So we always had the means to celebrate. Right lavishly. Towards the end of my life was when things went sour. But no point poking at old wounds. Just days before I died, my brother claimed he'd found a way to dig us out, restore our state.
Your brother sent me.
How is the old rogue? What I wouldn't give to ride by his side again.
No chance of that happening. Could experience something else, though. Something a corpse should find interesting.
Interesting? Out with it. What do you have in mind?
Don't mean to pry, but just a little curious how you died.
Bah! No need to be sh- Folk love such stories. I'd love this one, too. Were it not to end with my death.
So how'd it happen?
On raids, it was our custom to storm the alderman's hut and then order the local clods to bring us kegs of spirit and provide willing wenches to squeeze and churn about.
How just
then, sadly,
roguish of you.
Outmanned 5-1, we were overwhelmed. They killed me, crushed my skull like an eggshell between an upturned oak table and the stone floor.
Yikes.
Listen, feels like I should know Olgierd better. Tell me something about him.
Oh, a fantastic chap. A true cavalier. You won't find another like him in all Redania. The best there is for a drink or a brawl. We were pups when we started riding out on raids. Wet behind the ears. Borderland villagers shat their trousers. At the very sound of the word Olgierd, I was his second in command, leading a band of rogues who'd ride through fire for us.
Sound like common bandits. Any difference?
Us? Bandits? Watch your words. True, some of our swordsmen were mindless brawlers, but not Olgierd. Always curious, took an interest in all things. He devoured books, adored paintings, and loved the most beautiful maid in the world.
Well, gee, I feel like there's just a whole lot that I'm not being told somehow. Like, there's like something happened. What exactly happened to bring their fortunes down? And why were they raiding? Like, why were noblemen raiding? Like, who were they raiding? They're not from, like, the Isles. Skellige, you know? Like, they're from the mainland. Like, why? What are they doing?
Listen, Olgir gave me a job. Odd as it may sound, I need to show you the time of your life.
Is that so?
Now that, sir, is a brother. I've been dead for years, yet he still looks after me, after my spirits.
Is he older or younger than Olgir?
How much time do we have?
Think one night should do the trick?
Splendid. Wait just a moment while I hoist my saber and...
What?
What the blistering devils?
You're a ghost. Can't grab things.
Oh, I keep forgetting. But how am I to revel and rock and fuck? Can't lift a tankard to my lips. Can't wield a saber. Can't squeeze a wench as we dance a jig.
Gee whiz.
Guess you'll have to do without.
Sounds
Let's
just
go.
Like the worst thing ever.
I go nowhere.
How am You're I supposed to
see
make you
I enjoy
corporeal?
Myself, correct? Well, then think of a way to make it possible.
How?
Revive my flesh.
That's necromancy.
No, besides, body's probably decomposed.
Then bloody come up with another way. I'll not go anywhere in this state.
Guess I could bring someone here, and you. You could borrow their body just for the night.
You wish me to possess someone?
Yeah.
Say I agree. Whose body would I inhabit?
Dunno. One of Olgird's men, maybe? Or a peasant who'd agree to do it for coin?
Oh, no, no, no. I shan't crawl into the skin of some unwashed bandit, dung eating swineherd. I've a better idea.
Oh, no. Not gonna happen.
No!
Oh,
oh
yes.
No, no, no!
Yes,
no, 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 no! I thought it had to be, like, consensual?
Garrett, wake up. Open your eyes. Where are the smelling salts?
No, you're not touching Shani.
Death was a small price to pay to lie on a lap so lovely. And so near the one.
Oh, so stupid. Don't you even.
Yes, as soon as
oh
I
Oh my, I can't even handle this.
To stay
I'm taking my
chin,
headphones off.
And I shall spend the rest of eternity in a hound's body. Trotting along.
My headphones are off. I can't handle
calves.
This. It's stupid. So stupid.
Geralt? What's happened to you?
Geralt? I'm Vladimir.
Vladimir!
Fine, fine. Give me a moment. Yeah. Definitely don't like
you. Geralt! Geralt!
You'd not have fainted had you not resisted so fiercely.
Geralt, care to explain what's going on here?
It's all Geralt's fault.
It's his fault.
A pleasure to meet you, my sweet.
Whose?
His. You know, Olgird's brother.
Geralt, there's no one else here.
Oh, shoot.
Seems your lovely maiden friend can neither see nor hear me. There's potential in that.
Need to set a few ground rules.
And I needn't do a thing save have the time of my life. Which is exactly what I aim to do.
You're testing my patience.
As you are mine. Can you please explain what's going on here?
Ooh, fiery. Temperament matches the drapes.
Oh my gosh.
Listen, I'm supposed to show Vladimir von Evereck the time of his life. Turned out, he's a ghost. So, willing or not, I gotta lend him my body.
Wait a minute. Are you saying you're possessed?
Not at the moment. Just now he's standing next to me, coyly grinning at you. He'll enter my body, so anything I say or do will actually be him, his mind, his intent.
What if I want to talk to you, not him?
Well, she should approach me and ask me to jump out for a bit.
Just come up and ask him to leave for a while.
I see.
Splendid!
Right then, Sugar Plum.
Oh my gosh.
This dank crypt. There's a charming group.
I can't handle it. This guy is so lame.
Where else in the world?
I take it you're Vladimir now. Doesn't seem like I'll have trouble telling you apart from Geralt.
My sentiments exactly. Between you and me, this Witcher fellow is an awful bore.
Only sometimes.
Ha! Seems we're kindred spirits. So, off to the nearest hedgerow?
No!
I'm afraid I have to turn you down, dear ghost.
Dear ghost.
A shame. In that case,
oh my gosh, Geralt! No!
You see, I've a friend who's getting married. She invited me to the wedding, but I need an escort. I had hoped that when Geralt saw me weaving the garland for the wedding, he'd invite me, but, I looked wrong.
You can't just drop hints like that! I didn't know!
All is not lost, Pudding. I shall escort you. No better dancer in all Redania than Vladimir von Everick.
Wonderful. I must stop by my home first and change. So, we'll meet at the temple.
Oh, I don't like the sound of that.
Why not?
I'm not fond of temples, see? When alive, I'd only set foot in one to loot it. And in death, I find I despise them all the more. Could we not meet after the ceremony, go straight to the feast?
All right. Seems we've no other option.
Splendid. Then I shall see you at the wedding manor.
Oh my gosh. This is terrible. This is terrible.
I must say, Witcher, a man could lose his head.
Would everybody stop trying to set me up with Shani?
And that comes from none other than Vladimir von Everick, famed for his taste in women. So tell me, honestly now, man to ghost, are you her paramour?
No!
For if so, you have my word, I shall keep my distance. But if not, then... the haylofts we shall devastate together.
I really doubt it.
We're just friends, always have been.
Never professed your love.
Why?
No heartfelt confessions.
Nothing between us.
You mean to say you never gripped those gorgeous...
What?
Never cherished those beautiful, nay, stunning. So, soft in the head or the loins?
Oh, boy.
Excuse me?
Ah, a pederast. Fine, if it's not your flavor, you needn't taste. All the better for me. I'll see she's properly satisfied. So, Witcher, time for the wedding?
Let's go.
Onward. I'll be right behind you.
Are you gonna just follow me? You're not gonna possess me and walk around and taste the air and drink and revel
Grave
and...
Grave robber. Tried to crawl in through the well. Broke his neck.
Ah!
The scabby runt wished to rob our family crypt.
Oh, okay. So...
A comely maid. You're quite the fool if you've not plowed her yet.
Keep your paws off her.
I'm to enjoy myself. Can I help it that I best like tumbles in the hay with fleshy lasses?
Oh my gosh. You're just the worst. But apparently I was supposed to find this afterwards. So that Vladimir could make a comment on it. Are you just gonna be following me around and making comments the whole time? Cause this is just really awkward. I have literally zero interest in anything.
Why do you pour through my ancestors' bones?
I'm not. I'm trying to leave.
Wait, leave the dead to rest in peace.
I'm trying to get out, actually, but I don't. Is it this way?